Hello and welcome, dear traders and investors. I'm glad to present you the daily market review prepared by analysts and experts from FX.co portal. Here we go. And today we're starting from Eurodollar pair with Evangelos Poulakis. On the first day of the trading week, the euro pairs again gave in to the bulls. As a result, the euro-dollar pair returned to the zone of the previous consolidation. The bulls are focused on the defense of the resistant borders, such as 1.0758, a one-week short-term trend, 1.0844, the daily cross, and 1.0933, 1.0943, the upper border of the one-week cloud, plus a one-month medium-term trend. The bears aim to defend the following support levels: 1.0611, the upper border of the daily cloud, plus a one-month level, and 1.0461. 1.0479, the lower border of a one-week cloud, plus a one-week Feebuck in June. The 4-hour cloud has been broken at 1.0662, so the target has been hit. This price action halted a down move and enabled a correction climb. The bulls managed to take over the levels of the smaller time frames. Therefore, the euro bulls are setting the tone now. The support levels are 1.0702, 1.0719 serve as the key levels today. A breakout of the key levels will influence the balance of trading forces. If the bulls manage to protect these key levels and push the price higher, the next upward intraday targets will be the resistance of classic pivot levels such as 1.0749, 1.0776, and 1.0823. Gold, sweet gold. The trading plan for this commodity asset is presented by Dimitris Tsapas. Let's have a look. Early in the Asian session, gold was trading around 1855. Below the downtrend channel, which has been going on since early February, we can see that the price is consolidating. This is a sign that a strong move could occur ahead of fundamental news. Since last, weak gold has been consolidating around the area of 1850. According to the 4-hour chart, we can see that it is oversold, and a technical bounce above this level is likely. In case this scenario comes true, it could give us the opportunity to buy. Waiting for gold to return to the levels of the 200 MA located at 1876. This apparent calm in the market is due to investors awaiting the inflation data report to be released during today's American session. The annual CPI rate above 6.2% is bullish for the US dollar, and this could put pressure on gold. The metal could quickly fall to support levels of 1817. And the psychological level of 1800. On the contrary, in case the inflation data comes in below the consensus, gold could recover and quickly reach levels of the 21 SMA and the 200 EMA, and finally reach the psychological level of 1900. A sharp break above 48 Murray, located at 1875, could provide gold with an opportunity to recover in the short term and could reach 58 Murray, located at 1906. Conversely, a sharp break below 38 Murray could accelerate the bearish movement and the price could reach the 200 EMA on the daily chart located at 1799 or 28 Murray located at 1812. Our trading plan for the next few hours is to buy gold only if it consolidates above the daily pivot point located at 1856. With targets at 1870 and 1875. The eagle indicator is in the oversold zone. Hence, an imminent bounce is likely to happen in the next few hours. Petar Rikimovic describes how to trade USD-GBY pair. Dollar yen pair has been trading upside in the last couple of the days, and we found the breakout of the downside channel, which is good sign for further rise. Due to the breakout of the downside channel in the background and supporting price action, Petar sees potential for the further growth. Watch for the potential buying opportunities on the intraday dips with the upside objectives at 134.53 and 137.33. Slow MACD oscillator is showing bull divergence, which is a good sign for the further rally. Support zone is set at the price of 128.00. The next in line is Lowry Bailey with AUD-USD pair forecast. Yesterday, the Australian dollar bounced from the support of the MACD line and closed the day up by 47 pips. The price edged down this morning, and the morning oscillator shows the intention to turn down as it approaches the neutral zero line. The first sign of its intention to turn down is when the price crosses the MACD line 0.6910. A confirmation is when it crosses the support of 0.6873, which is the January 19 low. In case it succeeds, the 0.6730 target will become available. On the 4-hour chart, the price turns down from the MACD indicator line. The Marlin oscillator intends to move into the area of the downtrend for the second time. If the reversal does not succeed, after the price overcomes the 0.7012 high on February 9, the bulls will try to move into the target range at 0.7090, 0.7130.